Oh, that didn't work out. Ooh, she has like a cool dash. Get fucked! Okay. Okay. This is a real video game. I'm kind of all about this. This is really fun. Oh hell yeah! I am very good at the video game. Look forth, my son! The waters of Jomar are many main, bring blessings into this eve. Perhaps our chance has come at last. We need more than blessings to prevail against the Father. Please keep fighting. Yeah, you guys are gonna need a whole lot. What is that? What are those? I don't know what that does. Ooh! Infinite stamina? That seems really beneficial to get. Okay. So we have like the... Oh! We have the additional stamina regen thing, which seems really, really good. Fuck. Oh, shit. Eat shit. Oh. I want that. Oh, you guys left your fucking pyre unguarded. Y'all dumb. Y'all stupid. That was a big mistake that you made. Okay. That was dumb. That was my fault. Uh-oh. Hey, get out of here. Get out of here, friendo. Oh, it's unguarded! Yeah! That's not enough. That's not enough points, though. Okay. Oh, so our aura gets bigger if we're with a teammate. Oh, fuck. Okay. Okay. Fuck off. Fuck off. Oh, shit. Hey. Hey, no. Uh-oh. Hell yeah! They did not get a single fucking point. I am very good at this. Thank you.
Perhaps you shan't be quite so fortunate.
Oh, shut up. He's really rooting against us. We did it. Yeah, I mean, I guess. I wonder what will happen to the Fate. They seemed so nice, didn't they? Exiles of the Nightwings, the dawn is yours, and may you earn your freedom. But, Father, the dawn might have been ours. We failed, and I have failed you. Nonsense, we are the Fate. We do what is ordained, and nothing less. But let us go, my son, for I am weary once again. Aw. They seem nice. Oh, she got experience for... Even though she didn't participate. To that chums? Oh, yeah, okay, he gets a level up. We can jump a second time while airborne. Okay, yeah. Then he'll have normal points. Cool.
Until the stars align.
Hello, excuse me. I mean, would you excuse me for a moment, do you think? You're one of them. What do you want? Father needs me. Oh, I'm sorry. I think that I forgot what I was going to say. I'm so embarrassed. What is the matter with you? It is against the rights for us to even speak like this. I did not know that, I don't think. No one said anything like that to me, but then, all this, it's very new to me, and so I thought, maybe... You cannot be serious. Yes, I mean, I like to laugh a lot, and you... How about you? This is a Nightwing's trick. Father told me not to speak with any of you, but I have to go. Wait, Ulmer, wait, I think that was your name. Was that even your name? Wait. Oh, poor Bay. Bay seems nice. Bay's sweet. I like Bay a lot. Oh, what's up with that window? As he returned to the wagon after triumphing over the Fate, you notice Tredari all tense up and frown. Where did he go? Who? Wait, the sleeping guy? The minstrel. He's gone. You see, it is true. There's no trace of the lone minstrel who had been lying still in the corner of the wagon all this time. He joined the others in search for him outside. I did not even notice a minstrel. What are you talking about? Your fellow exiles have revealed nothing to you of the lone minstrel or how they found him, though you sense their concern as they scour the vicinity for him. We'll worry about the minstrel, my friend. You worry about the stars. Wherever they guide us, we're going. Okay. I did not notice another person in there. okay. Whoa! That place looks metal as fuck. Everyone, we're headed back east, all the way across the valley. Towards the Cairn of Hope, then. That's right, we have to risk it. What if that minstrel guy doesn't turn up by then? We shall find him, on this night or another. What's up with that guy? They continue searching for some time. However, the minstrel is nowhere to be found. Shit sucks, I guess. What's this? Oh. In the common room, you may review various notes and observations about your fellow exiles and their respective paths towards enlightenment and the rites. Oh, nifty. We had nothing for you. Okay. Cool. After having thwarted the fate with great prowess last night, you find your Daryl off on her own. You sense she wants to talk to you about your decision to exclude her from conducting the rite. Reader, you should know that I did not expect to be relegated to being a bystander in this. I respect your decision to exclude me in this case, though at the time I did not think the others would prevail without me. A lesson learned, even at my age. Now, if you would excuse me, we shall be departing soon. Oh, okay. She departs to check on things outside. You sense that she has no misgivings about what transpired, and is more concerned at present about the missing minstrel. Oh. Sick. Let us go then. There is still no sign of the lone minstrel, although Jodariel tracks potential signs of movement east, the same way you are headed. You consider where to search for him. We'll side with Jodariel just to make up for leaving her out of the last rite. As you make your way through the rocky pathways of Fall Flat, all there is to show for the missing minstrel is the deeper scowl on Jodariel's face. Blast. I felt certain that he would have taken our same route to the Spring of Jomor. It's alright, Jody. He could have gone anywhere. Likely there was nothing to be found either way. We should keep moving. You pick up bits and pieces of the minstrel's significance to your fellow exiles. He was there when they first discovered the Black Wagon, but they speak little more of it for now. Interesting. Who the fuck is this minstrel guy? It's not the wagon. What? How come? Because of her. They're coming! They're coming for us! We have to be ready! We have to! Does she mean what I think she means? I believe so. What? Your fellow exiles scramble to prepare the wagon for whatever is out there. Once you help them settle in, perhaps you can learn more of their source of concern. Okay. What's going on? They are coming for us. They fear the scribes! They fear the scribes! I know they do! What's she talking about? What's going on? Howlers. Lots of them. Then what are we going to do? They fear the scribes. Calm yourself, Bay. We shall give them reason to fear us as well. We'll use the raiments and the books. Indeed. One of us can draw them out under the reader's watch. It shall be just like one of our rites. Edwin turns to you. It seems we need your help in this, my friend. We just need a volunteer to go with you. I will do it, miss. Please. You have to let me and the scribes. They will protect me. I know they will. Jodariel exchanges looks with Hedwyn. Each of them nods to you as if to signal their approval. Okay. I don't know what's happening. But sure. I mean, I guess they can't just have the rites be the only bit of gameplay, right? The howling sound. It means they're here. Oh, by the scribes, they're here. Right. Fend off the howlers. Oh, I get money for it. Okay. Oh, wait, what's that? Ooh, okay. All right. Cool. This is a good power. Oh shit. Fuck off. Oh hell yeah. Good combo. I don't know what those, like, auras do. Wait, what? By power casting? Oh, I see. Okay. Oh, but power, but casting gets rid of my aura for a bit. Oh, it makes it slippery. I guess? More, I think. There's many more. Oh, no. Here they come. Here they come. Okay. Bay is good. I like Bay. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Fuck off. Go away. Whoa. Okay, holy fuck. That's a lot of them. Oh, fuck. Okay. Great. Did it. Is X1 flashing to power jump? Is it over now at last? It is. I think it is. Oh, those poor wretched beasts. Just then, Bay spots something creeping toward her. Whoa, what? Oh, hello. Can we have a pet? Can we get a pet? Oh, wait. Did it just, like... Did it just fuck up Bay? If it fucked up Bay, I'm gonna be very annoyed. The howling subsides as your fellow exiles scramble out to check out Bay. You find her in one piece along with an unfamiliar little face. Uh-huh. Isn't he the best? Can we keep him? You sense a depth of experience in this creature, at least judging by drive-up standards. In fact, you feel a connection to him. If you concentrate, perhaps you can derive some meaning from his calls and screeches. Dry Vamp seems both excited and frustrated by something. This Dry Vamp seems to have history with your black wagon. You're beginning to understand him. You can now understand this unusual Dry Vamp. The Dry Vamp seems satisfied at having gotten through to you, and you explain to your companions what little you have learned of him so far. No one argues against letting the creature come along. Inside the wagon, the other Dry Vamps stare at him with something like reverence. Okay. Okay. Weird. Hi! You can see the little imp has made himself at home. He rushes right up to you. Your new imp companion seems very pleased to be in the wagon. He indicates he was able to find you thanks to the swarm of howlers. He has no love of howlers, and they know not to mess with him either. He plans to set up a nest that should ward off any further trouble from them. He looks forward to the road ahead with everyone and believes it shall be worth it. He seems to be saying he is happy to be back where he belongs, and he urges you to keep going. He bounds off towards his brethren, settled in the wagon's rafters. Oh, yeah, they're, like, all over the place. Base status, prancing about. Oh, wait. Are these, like, little things where we can, like... Being consoled vegetarian. Being consoled... Oh, being consoled by about what? All right. What's up with that? Why can't I go there? Okay. We'll go here, I guess. Edwin ordered. Oh, that's where the right is. Duh. Hedwin orders the wagon to a halt somewhere in the barren wastes of Jomora Valley. There's someone on the road. Be careful, everyone. The figure watching the black wagon from afar approaches, arms spread wide, although a hat and cloak conceal the figure's features. Then the imp rushes out toward whomever it is. The imp is very riled up at the sight of whoever is approaching, though in an almost joyous way. Oh, it's the minstrel. Wow, you're a weird-looking dude. Tiso, it is good to see you, and you found the others, even faster than expected. The imp called Tizo appears very pleased. The lone minstrel turns toward the rest of you. Hello, we have not met, but I know who you are, or who you must be. I returned as promptly as I could. Have you walked with the scribes themselves, because I think maybe you have? Hello, indeed. You had us worried there when you took off. I should knock him back into his slumber. I did not aim to cause you such concern. As soon as I awakened, I had to notify my client that the Nightwings have returned. Your client? I am my client, Sandalwood. He is your point of contact, as I understand. You did not find his wagon by mistake. So, what now? You continue down the path. That is why I'm here. When we meet my client, he shall explain. For now, you have a job to do. I assure you that I shall not interfere. But I mean to accompany you. Would that be alright? Hedwin and the others exchange looks. Welcome back, minstrel. You got a name? I am sometimes called Tariq. It is a pleasure to meet you, Nightwings. The lone minstrel returns to the wagon with your fellow exiles. Alrighty then. Cool. So wait, is that not where... This is where our right is, right? Right? The Cairn of Hobe is a foreboding site. It is here that the next rite is soon to commence. Reader, if you have a moment, once we are settled on these grounds, I wish to speak with you in the wagon, at your leisure. Alrighty then. Oh, hey guys! Fancy running into you on the side of the sand. So, what can I do for you? Ron? How'd you make it all this way ahead of us? Ah, come on now, Mr. Greentail. Can't just give up all my business secrets, am I right? What I can do, though, seeing as you've been such a good customer and all, is provide for you a sample of a little something-something you might like. Here, check this out. Seeing as you bought that Mooncrest thinger from me last time, why, I'm just thinking you could use this, and I got more if you want. And just Stardust. Okay, thanks, Ron. The bearer's pyre automatically gains plus 7. Please be quiet, Ron. Like a talisman to enhance it. Usable once. Ooh. When plunging into the adversary's pyre, the bearer deals bonus damage. This one seems helpful. Oops. Oops. Ron, give me this. Yes. And I can buy... No, I can't. I'm poor. Let's buy that. Yeah. Okay. Lucrative contract. After banishing an adversary, the bearer gains plus 1 gold up to this many times per right. Okay. Sick. Bye. Let's equip people with some stuff. Oh, hey. Ooh, neat. Okay. So we can upgrade. Oh wait, hold on. Plus 2 quickness. Let's upgrade that. It didn't really improve anything. Let's see. Cool. I will give you that, and I will give Ruki that. Neat. Do you have another page? No. Why does it sparkle at me like that, then? Wait, why? Oh, wait. That was weird. Alright. Hey, minstrel. The lone minstrel seems to have situated himself in the wagon. He is very still, not unlike when he was sleeping. Reader, I shall keep this brief, as you shortly have a rite you must conduct. You have read something of the Book of Rites, which means that you may know something of my nature. On the contrary, you know not what he means, and he soon senses this. Forgive me, for I spoke too soon. Suffice it, I have served the Night Wings for some time. Conduct the rites with glory, and you shall achieve what you seek. The lone minstrel nods farewell to you and steps away. The lone minstrel and his white loot. Yeah, this is just tutorial stuff. Nothing for now. Cool. Let's do the right. Who we fighting? You and your fellow exiles gather around the sacred site known as the Care of Hobe, anticipating the hour that the rites are to commence again. All is quiet for a time, and then from out of nowhere charges a gangly cur. He stops short and gives you a mighty sneer. Psst. That's Barker Ashpaws. Real piece of work. Just don't make eye contact. Oi, well, would you look at this lot? Even got one of our own. Consorting with the two-leggers. You're a disgrace there, mate, you realize? Good to see you, Barker. You're looking well. Didn't know you knew about the rites. Oi, I know about a lot of things, my friend. For instance, I know you're going to be very, very sad after we wipe the floor with you here. Don't know whose back you scratched to earn yourself a spot in the high and mighty Nightwings there, but I'm going to make sure all of you regret it, because why not? Sounds good. Sounds good. The cur Barker laughs away as his pack stumbles after him. You hear them howling and cackling as the stars above begin to glow. Oh, this Barker guy seems like an asshole. And I'm going to be very happy to wallop him. Leave poor Ruki alone. Ruki's a good boy.
to the splendors of the accursed cairn of Haub.
Oh, I was saying that right.
We shall find the downside grows less pleasant from this point. But first, there's a tradition to uphold.
I suppose there is.
This time you stand against the dissidents. Even now they hunger to defeat you.
Yeah, they seem really eager to kick my butt.
Perhaps not simply to regain their freedom, but to deny you yours.
I like that the Pyres are like team logos. That's really cool. As the stars shine down upon you, the pack of curs you stand against this night continue hooting and howling. Oi, come on, you lot, let's boil some blood. Then Ruki pulls you aside. Look, sister, I don't know how to say this, but I can't go against these guys. Just trust me on this one, okay? You sense he means it, you make a mental note to ask about his history with Barker whenever time permits. It's alright, Ruki. We can take care of them. Begging your pardon, but if you need another to stand at your side this night, I have someone here whom I would recommend. Do not be coy with us, minstrel. Don the robes if you intend to stand with us. Oh, I did not mean for myself. The rites are not for me. I was instead referring to this little one. What? Tizo seems to be volunteering to take on your adversaries, the dissidents. Absurd. The imp knows the rites? He knows a great deal. So long as the Nightwings stand together, he shall be at their side. Though, you need not take my word for it. Tizo, our adversaries seem to be preoccupied. Perhaps you might quickly show our comrades what you can do? The little imp peers at you. You sense his connection to the rites as he awaits your guidance. Alright, what's he doing? Tizo seems excited to demonstrate some of his favorite tricks. Reader, influencing Tizo may take some getting used to. He is inviting you to try.
Another joins your ranks.
Okay.
And a mere imp.
Until stamina depleted. Ooh, he's got little hops. Implode. Whoa. He's also soon returns after imploding. Wait, do we have a taunt? Well done as ever, Tizo. Tizo is happy to lend his support during the rites, if you could use his help. Well then, Raider, we shall conduct the rites in the name of the Nightwings? Yeah. You. To make up for last time. And I mean, but I really like Bay. Bay is great.
It is done.
Our adversaries shall be quick. Be ready. Time's up, you swell. Come on, boys. Let's get him. What a dickhead. Okay. Alright.
Now begin.
Alright. We got this. Oh, we don't got this.
The adversary's aura or be banished.
Hell yeah. Okay, the cast is good. And you can't do the cast when you have the ball. Because the cast becomes the fling. Okay, headwind sprint is like the best one. Also, these guys are really, really bad. Hey, hey. Hey! Knock it off. Whoa, hey. Don't do that. That's not cool. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Oh, no. They had a fucking free net. Hey, guys. That's not cool. Oh, those are like air hockey pucks. Okay. Okay, well, if they're just gonna take out my folks, that's not cool. Yeah, you guys are... What are you doing? What the fuck? Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Oh, what? That didn't kill. Oh, wow. That was really fast. Oh, shit. Okay. Get fucked. Okay, wait. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Hell yeah. That one was actually kind of tough. Hell yeah. I wouldn't quite say that. Wow, that one wasn't mean. That ought to show them. Perhaps now they shall learn some humility. Well, well, I'll be a heaping ball of dung, but I just can't believe you shoddy lot showed us the what for like that. My boys and I will have to take you just a tad more serious next time. Till then, just be sure to tell old Grookey Greentail that yours truly, he remembers everything, you hear? Alright, that seems weird. I used to think the scribes were just the stuff of stories, but all of this, this really is their doing, isn't it? Sure. Bearing the orb, Hedwin and his allies move with and pass the orb more quickly. Ah. Ooh, that's also a good one to have. Oh, is the green experience like gray health? Like it doesn't do a level up until they partake in the rite? Alright, what do you got? Brief charge up time before Bay jumps or sprints is virtually eliminated. Oh, I should have looked at what that is. That was silly of me. Why did I do that? Splendid was your guidance of the Nightwings, reader. Your fellows are fortunate to have found one such as you. May you find freedom that you seek. Oh, thanks, Minstrel. You're a cool dude. I like you. You're nifty, and your design is very good. You can definitely see Supergiant like hitting their stride with designs with like between this and Hades. After prevailing over the dissidents almost effortlessly, you return to the wagon. It wasn't effortless, like they got a couple in. You return to the wagon to recover from the night's ordeal and figure out how best to proceed. You alright, Rookie? Think so, chum. I just need a little time. Didn't count on Barker being caught up in all this. You don't owe him your conscience. You'll sort things out with him, you always do. I do not wish to interrupt, but the darkened night is waning. Reader, would you join us outside, please? Sure. You find Jodariel and the lone Minchel gazing into the sky above the valley, which is beginning to grow pale. Where are we going? Oh. Northwest. Ooh. Interesting. Then, it is as I feared. We are to press further north, beneath the valley into flagging hands. The scribes are watching over us. They will protect us, wherever we should go. Had you been to Flagging Hands, you would not say such things. The scribes have surely turned their backs on that place. If I may, the bleakness of Flagging Hands shall wear upon you, to be sure. I urge for you to take what rest you can, for you shall need your strength upon the road ahead. Your fellow exiles agree to turn in for the remainder of the night. At dawn, you shall have to press deeper into the downside. Okay. Let's have a talk with Rookie. What's up? You can tell something is troubling Rookie, though he seems relieved to see you. Hey, sister, I got a level with you real quick. You remember Barker, don't you? Not exactly easy to forget, though believe you me, I try. Well, he's got me by the scruff. I've been down here a little while, as you can see by now. But Barker, he's been here longer. He's made quite the name down here. As for me, I needed help, you understand. I had a certain standard to uphold. So, I figured he would be the one to ask. Then, Rookie hesitates. Then, his familiar grin returns. So, what if I owe him, though, right, sister? I got people back on the other side, and just between us, we're loaded. I mean, rich. A little problem with Barker, soon it's going to take care of itself, just as soon as my people send the money through. That sounds unlikely. So, I am telling you right here and now, don't you even worry about it, and I'm sure everything on that front is going to end up real tidy, real soon. With that, he scampers off before you can respond. It seems Rookie owes a debt of some sort. What is on the line, exactly, you are unsure. Aw, cute. He has a little nest.